Let us now pray the Oratio Imperata for protection against COVID-19. Please all kneel. Merciful and compassionate Father, we come to you in our need to seek your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and claimed many lives. We ask you now to look upon us with love and by your healing hand, dispel the fear of sickness and death, restore our hope, and strengthen our faith. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. We thank you for the vaccines developed, made possible by your guiding hands. Bless our efforts to use these vaccines to end the pandemic in our country. We pray for our health workers that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. Grant them health in mind and body, strength in their commitment, protection from the disease. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in these trying times to work for the good of all and to help those in need. May our concern and compassion for each other see us through this crisis and lead us to conversion and holiness. Grant all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Amen. Our Lady, Health of the Sick,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
San Roque,
pray for us.
San Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
San Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, as we gather in this Eucharist this Saturday, we express our devotion to Our Lady, and we also take her as our inspiration and model. Our Lady, who got her direction and purpose in life always in God. To prepare ourselves to celebrate this Holy Mass, let us first acknowledge our sins and humbly ask the Lord for His pardon and mercy. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Pardon the faults of your servants, we pray, O Lord, that we who cannot please you by our own deeds may be saved through the intercession of the Mother of your Son and our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated. A reading from the book of Ecclesiastes. Rejoice, O young man, while you are young, and let your heart be glad in the days of your youth. Follow the ways of your heart, the vision of your eyes. Yet understand that as regards all this, God will bring you to judgment. Ward off grief from your heart, and put away trouble from your presence, though the dawn of youth is fleeting. Remember your Creator in the days of your youth, before the evil days come, and the years approach of which you will say, I have no pleasure in them, before the sun is darkened, and the light, and the moon, and the stars, while the clouds return after the rain, when the guardians of the house tremble, and the strong men are bent, and the grinders are idle because they are few, and they who look through the windows grow blind, when the doors to the street are shut, and the sound of the mill is low, when one waits for the chirp of a bird, but all the daughters of song are suppressed, and one fears heights and perils in the street, when the almond tree blooms, and the locust grows sluggish, and the caper berry is without effect, because man goes to his lasting home, and mourners go about the streets, before the silver cord is snapped, and the golden bowl is broken, and the pitcher is shattered at the spring, and the broken pulley falls into the well, and the dust returns to the earth as it once was, and the life breath returns to God who gave it. Vanity of vanities, says Koheleth. All things are vanity. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge.
In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge.
You turn man back to dust, saying, Return, O children of men, for 1,000 years in your sight are as yesterday, now that it is past, or as a watch of the night.
In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge.
You make an end of them in their sleep. The next morning they are all like the changing grass, which at dawn springs up anew, but by evening wilts and fades.
In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge.
Teach us to number our days aright, that we may gain wisdom of heart. Return, O Lord, how long? Have pity on your servants.
In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge.
Fill us at daybreak with your kindness, that we may shout for joy and gladness all our days. And may the gracious care of the Lord our God be ours. Prosper the work of our hands for us. Prosper the work of our hands.
In every age, O Lord, you have been our refuge. Please stand.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
our Savior Christ Jesus destroyed death and brought life to light through the gospel.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
While they were all amazed at his every deed, Jesus said to his disciples, "Pay attention to what I am telling you. The Son of Man is to be handed over to men." But they did not understand this saying. Its meaning was hidden from them so that they should not understand it. And they were afraid to ask him about this saying. Brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
My dear brothers and sisters, when we were seminarians, we had one theology professor. And he always repeated this to us. He would say, "Begin with the end in mind." Kapag magsisimula ka, sabi niya, kailangan nakikita mo na ang katapusan. Begin with the end in mind. You see, my dear brothers and sisters, that professor of ours was teaching us eschatology. Eschatology is the branch in theology that deals with life after death, about heaven and hell, about purgatory, about the end of this world, the end of our life. And so he would always tell us, begin with the end in mind. This is also the reminder of Jesus in our gospel reading today to his disciples. As they were going around preaching the word of God, as they were going around performing healing miracles to people, Jesus told his disciples, "Pay attention to what I am telling you," he said. "The Son of Man will be handed over to men so that he will suffer, he will be killed, he will die and offer his life for the people." Parang sinasabi palagi ni Jesus sa mga alagad, "We begin with the end in mind." And my dear brothers and sisters, if we do this, if we begin with the end in mind, then we will have a sense of direction, a sense of focus, a sense of purpose. Kapag nakikita palagi natin ang katapusan, nagiging maayos ang buhay. Nagkakaroon ng direksyon. Nagkakaroon ng patutunguhan. Di po ba napapansin ninyo yan sa atin? Kapag malapit na ang katapusan, doon mo inaayos lahat. Tama ba? Minsan kapag matagal pa yung katapusan, paisi-isi ka lang, no? Pero kapag malapit na yung deadline mo, ayan na, no? Kailangan ayusin ko na lahat kasi deadline na. Kaya kapag ganyan ka palagi, nagmamadali ka sa deadline mo, marami kang pagsisisihan sa huli palagi. Naku, sayang, hindi ko nagawa ito. Sayang, no? Sana hindi ako nagmadali sa huli. Sayang, maaga ko sanang sinimulan ito. Kasi you did not begin with the end in mind. Kaya kapag ganyan ang ating ugali, nagsisimula tayo na nakikita na natin ang katapusan, magkakaroon ng ayos, magkakaroon ng direksyon, magkakaroon ng purpose ang iyong mga ginagawa. This is also the reminder of our first reading today from the wisdom of the book of Ecclesiastes. He said, "Rejoice, O young man, while you are young. Enjoy your life while you are young." But the first reading said, remember, you are not young forever. Time will come when you will pass from this life. You will become dust again. And in the next life, God will judge you, whatever you have done in this world. Mabuhay ka, maging masaya ka sa iyong pamumuhay, pero tandaan mo, magtatapos din ang buhay mo. At anuman ang ginawa mo sa mundong ito, ay huhusgahan ka ng Diyos. We live and begin living with the end in mind. And life will become more meaningful if we begin life with the end in mind. Kaya po, huwag na nating hintayin ang katapusan bago pa man tayo mamuhay ng maayos. Huwag na nating hintayin na naghihingalo na tayo at dun mo pa ipapatawag ang mga kaaway mo para mag-sorry ka na hindi ka na makahinga at hindi ka na makapagsalita. Ngayon pa lang, mag-sorry ka na sa mga inaway mo. Ibalik mo na ang mga inutang mo. Makipagkasundo ka na sa mga kaaway mo. Begin with the end in mind. Alam niyo po, dito sa sacristy ng Manila Cathedral, kung saan naghahanda kaming mga pari bago magmisa, ay mayroong nakalagay na napakagandang paalala sa amin. Sabi doon, "Celebrate your Mass as if it was your first Mass, as if it was your only Mass, and as if it was your last Mass." Sabi doon, kapag magmimisa ka, ipagdiwang mo ang misa mo kagaya ng ito ay parang una mong misa, parang ito ang natatangi mo at nag-iisa mong misa, at parang ito ang pinakahuli mong misa. Kaya tuloy pag nagmimisa ako, pakiramdam ko, this will be my last Mass. And you will give everything if this will be your last Mass. This is a reminder to us that you will not live forever. Time will come, your life will end. And it is good that you begin every act with the end in mind. Kaya kapag gigising kayo sa mga mag-asawa dito, pagising ninyo, kapag nag-I love you kayo sa asawa nyo, do it as if it was your last I love you to your husband or wife. If you will kiss your children when you go out of the house, kiss them. Remind them of your love as if as if it was the last time you will do it for them. I think every day will be special if we think that will be the only and the last time you will do it. And if we think about that always, every day will be always a special day, a very important day to live, because you begin with the end in mind. My dear brothers and sisters, our inspiration this morning is Our Lady. At the early age of Jesus, Mary was already aware that time will come when his son will suffer. And it will be, according to the gospel, like a dagger that pierces her heart. But according to the gospel readings, Mary kept all these things in her heart. She was prepared. She knows that one day Jesus will suffer on the cross and she will suffer with him. But she also believed that after 3 days, she also will be glorified with the resurrection of Jesus. Mary's life had a direction. Mary's life had a focus. Mary's life had a purpose, because she began with the end in mind. My dear brothers and sisters, let us pray that in this Eucharist, Jesus might teach us how to put direction into our lives by always beginning with the end in mind. Amen.
Please stand.
Christ our Lord predicted his saving death and resurrection. Through him, the suffering servant, let us bring our petitions to the Father of all mercies. For every petition, let us say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the leaders of the church may show us a clear vision of patient endurance in the turmoil of our time. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That peace and harmony may reign among nations and among the world's people. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may realize that true greatness is not a matter of power and respectability, but is to be found in the service of others. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick may unite their sufferings with those of Jesus on the cross. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dead may be freed from their sins and enjoy everlasting peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In silence, let us now pray for our personal intentions and for all the intentions offered in this Mass. Heavenly Father, give us the courage to accept whatever sufferings may come our way on the path of life. Lead us into the fullness of joy in your presence. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Accept, O Lord, the offerings we bring you, and grant that, enlightened by the Holy Spirit and encouraged by the example of the Blessed Virgin Mary, our hearts may always seek out and treasure the things that are yours. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, to praise your mighty deeds in the exaltation of all the saints, and especially as we celebrate the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to proclaim your kindness as we echo her thankful hymn of praise. For truly, even to earth's ends, you have done great things and extended your abundant mercy from age to age. When you looked on the lowliness of your handmaid, you gave us through her, the author of our salvation, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us now offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Brothers and sisters, the body of Christ.
Amen. Please stand.
Let us pray. Having received the sacrament of salvation and of faith, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that we who devoutly honor the Blessed Virgin Mary may be worthy to share with her in the charity of heaven. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A gentle reminder again to everyone that this coming Monday, our regular schedule of Masses at 7:30 a.m. and 12:10 in the afternoon will be canceled just for this Monday to give way to the event here at the Manila Cathedral of the Office of the Promotion for New Evangelization, which is the event celebrating Asia in Manila. And so we advise everyone, especially our daily Mass goers, that on Monday, we will not have the 7:30 a.m. and 12:10 p.m. Masses. And we would like also to thank everyone who have joined us in this Saturday Eucharist, especially the pilgrims who may have come from different places and parishes around Metro Manila and even outside Metro Manila. Thank you for visiting our Mother Church, the Manila Cathedral, and the home of Our Lady, the Immaculate Conception. May she continue to intercede for you and pray for you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless all of you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth. The Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Maria, Ina.